So I want to explain today why a logarithmic scale is useful in showing pandemic data. So I'm stuck at home here in Belgium, but still I'm improvising a bit for material, you see. So let's look at the normal linear scale. So this is a very intuitive process process to look at. For instance, let's think that we come back from holidays with no chicken eggs in the fridge, and then I go. So this is day zero. So on the vertical axis I have eggs, and on the horizontal axis I have days. And so day zero I have zero eggs, but then after one day I have two chickens, so I will have two eggs. So one day, two eggs. So we have a data point here. Another day has passed, and so again two eggs are added to my fridge. After 2 days there will be four eggs in my fridge. And once again, if I wait another day, of course there will be six eggs in my fridge. So this is the third day, and it will be six eggs. And you see that all these points lie on a straight line, as you expect. So this is the line that occurs when there's an addition of things to your inventory. So this is the example of the eggs, but it happens in many other cases. For instance, when you have a bank account, if you have a bank account where you add, let's say on a monthly basis, a fixed sum of money, so then it's also a linear increase in money in a bank account. Let's now look at another process. So if you, for instance, look at the number of cells in an embryo after it gets, an egg gets fertilized. So when the egg gets fertilized, there's one cell in this embryo. But then after some time, the cell will divide and there will be two cells. So after some time, there will be two cells. So then we have a data point here. At one day, at one time, and two cells. But then, sometime later, at the same time, you will have again a multiplication by two, because each cell will split into two. And then, so after two time steps, we will be at four cells. And then when we go one step further, once again, you multiply by a factor 2, and so in step 3 you will be at 8 cells, right? And when you go to step 4, as you already can predict, you will be at 16 cells. And so it's even dropping off the cardboard here, so 16 will be here. And so then you see this is called an exponential increase. So it starts from 1 and then it increases rapidly to 16 in just as a matter of days. And so there are also many, so the key point here is that there's multiplication or division, whereas previously we had addition and subtraction. So there are also many examples of these sorts of processes. There's an investment with a certain set interest rate. In that case, for instance, if the interest is 1% each time, your amount of money will be multiplied by 1.01 after every year. So that will be compound interest in the investment. But also, for instance, radioactive decay. When you halve the content of your radioactive material in a certain amount of time. So the key point is that everything is multiplied in a certain time step. This is an exponential growth. So you see already the problem occurring with this linear scale is that it clearly doesn't fit on the graph. Let's say I'm clever, then you could look at a graph and you know that after 5 days you will end up with 32 cells in your embryo. So you put the data point here and then you track back what fits on your graph. So after 4 days there will be 16 cells, after 3 days there will be 8 cells, 2 days there will be 4 cells, 1 day there will be 2 cells, and just 0 days is 1 cell. But you see that it once again it doesn't show very well what is happening now in the beginning. So that's why people invented or use the logarithmic scale. So logarithmic scale uses a trick. Basically, it's a representation of the same data. So on the horizontal axis, once again, we keep the same number of days. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now on the vertical axis, instead of spacing it linearly, like in the linear scale, we space it logarithmically. So here we start from 1, but then after one day, we multiply by 2. So then we end up with 2. But then progressing further, we don't stick to 3, but then we jump immediately to 4. So then we have 4, now we put the data point here, so then we go from 1 to 2 to 4, and in the sense that you multiply every time with a factor of 2. And so after 4 days you will have 8 cells, and then 16 cells after 5 days. And so you see now, once again, you recover this as a straight line, and so that's the advantage of this logarithmic scale, that it shows this exponential growth when you multiply with the factor with a straight line. The caveat is that now on the vertical axis you don't go from linearly from 1, 2, 3, 4, you go from 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. So you multiply for each step with the same number.
Okay, here we see a first example of the use of this logarithmic scale. So the both graphs show the same data points, and these are data points for the number of cases of this new virus as a function of time in the China Wuhan city. Where on the left hand side you see the data points shown in a linear scale, but on the right hand side you see them shown in a logarithmic scale. So on the left hand side you see that indeed the data points, the number of cases is increasing very rapidly, but that's the only thing that it shows. Whereas on the right hand side in this logarithmic scale you see that initially there is this exponential increase in the number of cases, which is shown with a green line. Then after a while the Chinese government is starting to take some measures against the virus, then the data points are starting to veer away from this exponential increase. And so you see that this logarithmic scale is showing this much more clearly than this this linear scale on the left hand side. And here's a second example showing the usefulness of this logarithmic scale. So on the left hand side, once again, the red data points are data points of number of cases, but this time for Italy as a function of days. And so this graph was made by my colleague Giorgio Zhao from K Leuven. And so on the right hand side, the same data points are shown, but now in logarithmic scale, on the vertical axis, number of people, and on the horizontal axis, the date. But there you see very clearly when the measures were taken by the Italian government to go into lockdown. So first there's this exponential growth in the first part of the curve, indicated with the yellow line. But after the lockdown took place, you see very clearly the change to this slower growth, which is shown in the green line. And this is very clearly visible once again in this logarithmic scale, but does not show at all in this linear scale on the left-hand side.